Jean Guinista and Gabriel Joyal are part of the mapping team aboard the Amundsen. They collect data that measures the depth of the Arctic seafloor and the conditions of the water at these depths. They use two important pieces of equipment, the moving vessel profiler and the multibeam Echosounder.
Basically, the moving vessel profiler, together with the fish, are used to measure parameters in the water column, and the fish will go down in the water column close to the seabed, come back up towards the surface, and when it reaches against the surface, it will just drop back down. So it continuously takes these profiles and measures in the water column different sorts of data that include the speed of sound in the water, the temperature, and the dissolved oxygen content that are used by different teams on board Amundsen. So a multibeam, unfortunately, we can't really see it right now because it's directly fixed on the keel of the boat, so it's permanently underwater. And the multibeam basically sends out sound waves and measures the two-way travel time to the seabed and back up. So it gives us the water depth, and as we're moving forward, we're measuring a strip of the seafloor. And if we're interested in sort of a rectangular area, then we would simply have the boat turn around and do another pass just side of the first strip. And that's how we get a three-dimensional picture of the seabed. And we call actually that mowing the lawn. Or for Canadians, maybe it would be actually passing a Zamboni on an ice rink.
As the sea ice continues to melt in the Arctic, new marine channels are opening up that have never been seen or even sailed through before. The 3D maps that Jean-Guy and Gabriel make can help the shipping and natural resources industries guide their vessels safely through these new waters.